Hi everybody, back again with yet another video. This is a project that's in progress at the moment. I haven't finished it yet. I've got another couple of figures to get and a couple of little items to get, and then hopefully it'll be finished and I'll be able to set it up and do a video of it sometime. It's based on the Tony Stark workshop kit that was released. I do have the workshop and I also have a few other accessories that go with it. It's going to be a diorama. I'm hoping to get some of the Hall of Armour cases as well to put some of the Iron Man figures in, but that'll be at a later stage. But I just thought I'd show you some of the figures so far that I've got that I'm going to be using in that setup. So we start over here. This is Tony Stark himself. This is obviously from the workshop version. There's a few extra pieces I'm going to put on him. I have got the actual bicep items that you can buy that will be put on there, but that's virtually Tony Stark done. Next to him we have Bruce Banner. Then we have my Kitbashed Black Widow. Now, as you notice, these are all in civilian gear, which is what I wanted to go for. So this is a Kitbashed Black Widow. I might change the head, put one of the newer ones on, but I'm not sure yet. Tell me what you think. Next to her, we have my Kitbashed Pepper Potts. Obviously, Hot Toys are releasing a Pepper Potts, which I have got on order. So I might use that one instead of this. But this is the one that I've got so far. Next to him, we have Captain America, obviously Steve Rogers. This is from the twin box set, but I actually bought this one separate. And I have his shield there, which will also be on display on the diorama. Next to him we have my Kitbashed civilian Thor. I will go over these figures individually in a little while in this video and tell you what I've used. And next to him we have the Hot Toys Agent Phil Coulson. So before I move on to the figures individually, what I also want to use is the Infinity Stones. Now, Hot Toys have actually released four. A lot of people might have missed it. But the first Infinity Stone is in the scepter here. It's the actual Mind Stone that they used to make Vision. So I will have that on display. And over here we have the Tesseract, which is also an Infinity Stone. The other stones that Hot Toys have released, with the Star-Lord exclusive figure, you get the artifact that comes with the exclusive figure. That is also an Infinity Stone. And with the Dark World Thor exclusive figure, you get the ether, which is held in a container which lights up. I've got both of those on order. Well, I've actually got the Infinity Stone with the Star-Lord. I bought that recently. But I've just ordered the Ether Infinity Stone. So that should be coming soon. And I'm hoping that Hot Toys will release the other two Infinity Stones with future figures when those films come out. I don't know if they'll release one with Thanos. Wouldn't have thought so. But I would expect Hot Toys will release the other two as exclusives as well, and when they do, I will get them. So what I'm going to do is put a pause in here. Before I do, you might notice there's a couple of figures missing. Nick Fury. I want to add Nick Fury to this as well. I did have a Nick Fury figure. I've sold him, and that's because I've ordered the new Nick Fury. It's because he's more lifelike on the head sculpt, which is why I decided to sell my Nick Fury and get him. So when he comes through, he will be added to this little diorama as well. And also, I've got to make a civilian version of Hawkeye. So that will be my next figure that I will be hoping to sort of kitbash up as a civilian. But at the moment, the Hawkeye head sculpts are quite expensive. I might go for a custom one. But that's just something that I'm planning at the moment. So I'll put a pause in here and we'll just take a quick look around each figure individually. Okay, here we have Tony Stark. It does have a light up chest arc reactor. You can just see it underneath there, and these do light up as well, but I'm not putting the batteries in. I've taken all the batteries out because I don't want them to leak. But this is the workshop version. What I'm planning on doing is changing the head sculpt. I might get the newer Tony Stark head sculpt to put on this, just to make it a bit more current. But as I say, this is the workshop version. All I've done is just taken his normal shoe off and put the part of his Iron Man suit over the top. And I've done the same with the arm. As I say, he does have some bicep armour, which I've also got, and he will be displayed with that on as well. But I love the look of this figure. This is the only Tony Stark that I've got now. I did have a few of the others, but I sold them because I only really wanted one, and this is the one that I plumped for. It's not a bad head sculpt, but I think the current head sculpt that is out at the moment is slightly better than this one. Obviously, it's an older looking face, which just makes it more current. So that's Tony Stark. Put a pause in now and we'll take a quick look at Bruce Banner. Okay, here we have Bruce Banner with the first of the Infinity Stones. This is the Mind Stone. If you've seen the Age of Ultron, this is the one that actually the Vision has on his forehead. His little Infinity Stone is actually inside the blue bit. Again, another nice looking figure. The head sculpt isn't too bad. You can see it's Mark Ruffalo. Tailoring's really nice. But he's good enough for what I want. I'm not really going to change this one. You can buy him with the 2-pack of the Hulk. It's quite expensive though. Or you can buy him singly, which is what I've done. Because I've since sold my Hulk. Because I'm getting the new Age of Ultron version. I think I mentioned it in my last video. Mainly because it's more movie accurate. And it's not as green as the original release. And I don't like my Hulks being really green. That makes it too comic booky. It's not a bad head sculpt. You can see it is the actor. So there's Bruce Banner. We'll now move on to my kitbashed civilian Black Widow. Okay, here we have Black Widow. Kitbashed out. I have done a video on this one previously, but I've just added basically I took the weapons off that I had on her and just put this black leather jacket on. It's not movie accurate clothing wise. I just thought it looked sexy just to keep with the Black Widow sexiness that she has. The body underneath is the Hot Toys Ada Wong seamless body, and with the feet as well. The clothing, I believe, is just typical Triad Toys type clothing that you can buy readily on eBay. And the head sculpt is the original Black Widow release by Hot Toys from the Iron Man 2 movie. Said, I'm not sure if I'm going to keep this one or not. I might put one of the newer head sculpts on. I haven't decided yet. But I just thought Black Widow in a civilian guise would have her hair down. Although in the newer films it's cut shorter. But let me know what you think. Should I keep with this head sculpt or change it out for one of the newer ones? But I like the way this has turned out. It's very simple to do. Put together, not a problem. And the Ada Wong body is very good actually for kitbashing. The only real problem is the feet. You've got to swap them out if you want to change them over. But other than that, it is a fantastic body for kitbashing. It's much better for kitbashing than I would say the Fison bodies. The Fison bodies, the skin is very, I wouldn't say sticky, but it's difficult to put clothing on Fison figures. This one is a lot easier. So I'll put another pause in here. We'll come back. We'll have a look at my kitbashed Pepper Potts. Okay, here we have Pepper Potts. She's got a Fison seamless body underneath. It's not the stainless steel one. Actually, yes, it is. This is the new stainless steel flexible body underneath. One thing you have to be careful of with these stainless steel flexible bodies is the feet. The toes are very easy to break off because there's no metal or anything going down into the toes, so they just flap about a bit, so it can be a bit of a pain. This one came through broken, but it's hidden by the shoe. Clothing, again, just normal 1/6 scale clothing that you can easily find on eBay, not a problem. I'm not entirely happy with this figure at the moment. I will be doing some more work on it. I might change the top. But these bodies are fantastic. If you want a really nice nude female body, then you've got to go for these new Fison seamless stainless steel skeleton flexible bodies. They vary in price. I've seen them going for about 60 quid up to about 80 quid on eBay. The head sculpt is, I think it's a Kumik head sculpt. I need to put some blue tack in there though, because this is a bit of a pain for putting head sculpts on. I've had to dig out the inside of this one because there's just no way was it going on there. And what I'm going to do, as I say, is put some blue tack in there so it will stick on the neck peg nicely. But at the moment, it's the best Pepper Potts custom head sculpt out there. They're readily available on eBay. It's all plastic apart from the hair at the back. That's been sort of rooted in to the ponytail. But as I say, Hot Toys are bringing out a Pepper Potts very soon, which I do have on order. So I might use that one instead of this. But this is good for the moment. That is nothing. I've just put some black stuff around the wrists to hide the wrist pegs, because this top is a bit short, which is why I'm definitely going to change the top so I can get one that comes down that covers the wrists. So that's only temporary at the moment. But all in all, not a bad look. So I'll put another pause in here. When we come back, we'll take a look at Steve Rogers. Okay, this is actually the Hot Toys Steve Rogers in his civilian gear. This came as a two-pack with the Stealth Strike suit version of Captain America. I didn't buy the twin pack because I didn't really want this figure at first. So I just bought the normal single Stealth Strike suit version. But because I come up with this idea that I wanted to do this diorama, I wanted this figure. So I went on eBay and managed to pick one up. Fairly cheap, not too bad a price. A bit less than a normal Hot Toys figure. But you won't find many of these on eBay on their own. Great looking head sculpt. Tailoring is superb. I believe this head sculpt also comes with the new Age of Ultron Captain America figure. So if you want to kitbash your own, then there's an idea for you. Get that figure and you get this head sculpt. It also comes with the shield. I thought I'd come with the figure as well, and it'd be great to use this in the diorama as well somewhere in Tony's workshop. I will put this, but yeah, it's a great looking figure, good articulation on it, probably the best example out there of Steve Rogers at the moment. I'm sure Hot Toys will release another head sculpt of this. I don't think there's going to be many Captain Americas made now, because whether they'll do it in the film or not, but the new Captain America movie, the Civil War movie, Captain America dies. I don't know if they'll do that in the film. Might be a spoiler alert for people who don't know. If they follow the comic, then that will probably be the last film you will see Captain America in. He gets killed by the daughter of Agent Carter. That was the girl that he was in love with when he was around in World War II. So it's either a daughter or a granddaughter. I haven't really read the comic, so, but she actually kills Captain America, and she is in the Civil War movie, from what I can see. So, you know, will he or won't he? We'll have to wait and see if they'll kill him off or not. So I don't think there'll be many more Captain America figures being made. Which is great for me, because I don't really want to keep swapping my Captain America figures. So I'll put a pause in here, and when we come back, we'll have a look at my kitbashed civilian Thor. Okay, here we have Thor. All I've done with this is the clothing is the extra Barney Ross clothing that comes with the Expendables 2 figure. I thought this was a great idea to use these with this figure. It's okay, it's not movie accurate clothing wise. I'm not really too bothered about that. I just wanted to have a civilian look. The body underneath is the latest Hot Toys muscular body, two type muscular body. It's probably a little bit big in the legs, but Thor is a big guy. The head sculpt is the Dark World head sculpt Thor. So I might change this for the new Avengers head sculpt, because I think it's slightly different, and I might change it out for that one at some point. And the Tesseract, this came with, I'm just trying to think now, I think it came with the original Thor, not the original Thor figure, but it, I think it did come with a Thor figure, or it might have been Loki. I'm not sure, I can't remember offhand, but I had to actually go out and buy this one on its own. Thor, that's it, it came with the Thor figure, just remembered. And this is another of the Infinity Stones. So that's two of the Infinity Stones. It's just a generic stand. You can buy these readily on eBay. This is the crotch stand. You've got the ring stand as well. C-ring stand, which I think is the best one. I might change that eventually for a C-ring stand. It just holds the figures a lot better. Less chance of them falling over. And you can pose the figure a bit better with a C-ring stand. So yeah, there's Thor. And now we'll move on to Agent Phil Coulson. And here we have the last of my figures at the moment, until I get the other two for this diorama that I will be doing. And I will do a video of that when it's done. It'll be a while yet though. But this is the Hot Toys Agent Phil Coulson. Very underrated figure. I love this figure. It's absolutely superb. The tailoring is brilliant. It does look like him. Comes with some pretty good accessories as well. As you can see, I've got some of his accessories on him. He's got the shield portfolio there of somebody or something that they're building. I have done a video on this guy in the past, so check back on that. Got him with his mobile phone in his hand, and obviously his radio. He's got his gun there. Also in his pockets I have put the cards that he has, the Captain America cards, and he does come with this, which is Shield's invention for a gun. It does light up. Again, I've taken the batteries out just in case they leak, but I'll have this on display as well in the diorama when I get it up and running. Great looking gun, this. Not going to show it on the figure because it's a bit heavy and it does tend to pull him forward a little bit. But yeah. So that's Agent Coulson. Show you a look without his glasses on. So it does look like the guy who plays him. Can't remember his name offhand. I'm sure somebody will put a comment below. So I'll put another pause in here, put him back with the other characters, and just have a final roundup. So there you go. That's my civilian figures as it stands at the moment. There's actually three more that I want to add. I've just remembered another one. I've got to make my kitbashed civilian version of Hawkeye, which is what I will be working on over the next month or so to get him done. And when he is done, I'll post a quick video on him. Obviously, Nick Fury, when the new one is released, which I don't think it's been released until next year. So you're looking at least middle of next year before this diorama is finished. So when he comes, I will add him to this as well. And also, it's the, is it Melissa Hill or something like that? The Kobe Smulders character from the Avengers movies. She is being released by Hot Toys. So I will add her to this collection as well. So that's just another three. I don't think there's any more characters really you can add to this. I'd love to get the Stan Lee figure that's been released, but that's just way expensive for what it is. And I'm not going to pay out that sort of money for that. But yeah, I'm surprised other people haven't actually done this. Maybe they have and they just haven't done a video on it. Or maybe people will now think, cool, that's a great idea. I think I'll do that. Jump on the bandwagon and obviously get the video out there before me. That's fine. But I think it's a really good idea to have the Tony Stark workshop diorama with extra accessories, which I do have, other bits and pieces, and just have all these characters sort of standing around discussing their plans on what they're going to do. But as I say, before I actually finish, I've got to get those three other figures, some suit of armour, display cases, which is going to be expensive. They're expensive for what they are, so I might make my own, I don't know yet. So I want to buy those to show my Iron Man suits off. So yeah, there you go. Tell me what you think so far. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see all you guys on the next video. Take care.